So, welcome friends in the new project of Journey with Dr. Kalathia series. In this series, we have an online repertory training course that already you know. It's about a kind of awakening importance of repertory to the maximum homeopath that we try. So this is our main motto. So let's talk little more about this course, what we are going to do in the series of talks and what other activities are involved in this project. So let's do. First of all, I warmly welcome you all, colleagues, senior homeopaths, my team. So, heartily welcome you all. Now, it's a kind of a training course, right? So, it's not kind of dry lecturing as we have in seminars and colleges. But, actually, we are giving you training. So, it has a kind of a clinical importance. It's a practical training. We are going to cover maximum topics in repertory. But honestly say it's a short course, short term course. It's not a very long term course. So most probably we'll finish the course in 30 to 45 days. But question here arises in everybody's mind, like why only repertory? There are many things in homeopathy, and even it's more interesting than repertory. Then why I choose a course on repertory? So there are several reasons, but main reason is repertory has a beautiful results in practice. But our tragedy is we hardly know something about repertory. So this is the main reason I selected a repertory to create this huge global awareness. Another thing, in college time also we are not giving so much importance to repertory. We study Materia Medica and Organon and everything. But repertory is not so important in college days also. Actually, the repertory is not something alien kind of thing, but it's a tool, one of the tools. Like different tools we are using in our practice, like keynotes, provings, Materia Medica, therapeutic knowledge and concepts, various concepts, theories, as for example Sankaran's sensation method, Vijaykar's predictive method, Segal method, ICR method, Double method, many other methods are there, Vitulkas method. So this is we call concepts. So these are a kind of tools that we use in our practice. So repertory is one of the tool. But I want to share why repertory is very important. Suppose I take example of therapeutics. Any person has a injury, then we will generally will arnica or calendula, because these medicines are known since centuries for injuries. So, this way we are matching the disease of the person with the disease of the medicine. But actually in homeopathy, we are not matching disease. We need to match symptoms. And if you have to match the symptoms, you have to take help of repertory. Because each and every person has malaria, they have different symptoms. According to us, according to homeopathy. So this is main important thing. And this is the reason repertory has big value in practice. It gives really good results. I say you can trust the repertory by heart. That much it is very very valuable. And it shows the value, because this much of homeopath joined the course, right? Even experienced homeopath who has practiced since 20-30 years, they also join the course because they want to learn something, they want to improvise. And this is, you can say, the basic fundamental quality of homeopath. This is need to be there in each and every homeopath. You need to be student throughout your life. You need to improvise. You need to grow every day. This is necessary. So, this is the way the repertory has weightage in the practice. But somewhere we are lacking. And I am not guarantee you, like, I make you master in repertory within 30 days. But I will try my best, and main probably we will show you the way how you can learn the repertory. But there are many things you can expect from us. Like, you have big expectations, so many homeopaths join the course, so it should be something very big. And after the completing the repertory course, you might become a very successful homeopath. You have a lot of successful cases, or you can learn a lot of things. This might be expectation you have, but I'm sorry friends, this is not exclusive course. We are creating just awareness about the repertory and how to work with the repertory. And it's important. So you can learn a repertory whatever way you can. And this is our main motto. So, but it's not something completely useless course. You can learn lot of things. We are giving you lot of small information. It's not, you can say, the compact course. This is a very very tightly bound course, where we give many things together in small packets. So now let's talk about repertory and what we try to make you understand in this course. So, actually, if you have to master the repertory, then from the initiation you have to, at first stage, you have to look, you have to look for the symptoms, a common and very easy symptoms in repertory. So that kind of rubric you have to find out. This is the first stage. And my humble request for students, they have to try out this first stage in their life. Suppose I give you peculiar symptoms or something big or huge task, then it's very difficult. Even students are not able to recognize the peculiars, because it's matter of practice. You require a lot of exercises. Then after you find out the peculiar. We, as a homeopath, we have a lot of importance for peculiar, and our prescription is always on base of peculiars. But you also have to study common symptoms. And common symptoms are very important in acutes, and especially beginners homeopath. Because the easy symptoms, like somebody says, I have a headache and I have a pain on my right side, these symptoms you are easily able to find out in repertory. But somebody says, like in coma, the patient is moving their hands like this, you are not able to find the rubric for this, because it's a very peculiar, right? So, this way. Second thing, many students ask me to, they want to learn mental symptoms. But as per my advice, from the very beginning, stay away from the mental symptoms. If you are a student, if you are starting a practice with repertory, initially do not focus on mental symptoms because it's art kind of thing. You have to look in repertory something which is very peck kind of things. Like somebody has a ear pain, then it's pain. You do not have a chance to interpret them. These kind of symptoms you have to look in repertory. But somebody says, my hand is very big, or somebody explaining and bolstering all the things, and you try to find out some kind of typical delusion in repertory chapter. It's a very difficult. And rather than difficult, repertory is not something that you have to just learn. It's something just put you directly in the front of clinic. It's a clinical thing. So, if you want to learn mental symptoms, learn it, no problem. But in practice, do not directly go and jump in the mental symptoms in clinic. First, try to have a grasp over the common and peculiar symptoms to find them and use them, because this is the way you gain the trust on repertory. Once you have a case, you selected 3-4-5 symptoms, on that base you have a group of remedies, and from each one you selected and it gives good results. Then you have a trust on that symptoms, like these symptoms I have selected and it gives good results. So this is you need to have at first level. Another thing, there are many other concepts, many understanding, therapeutic, understanding of medicine, personalities, many things are there. Kingdom, classification, subkingdom, miasm, predictive way, Segal style, ICR, and Vithilkas. These all things are there in practice, and they are not even useless. I say each thing has their own value in practice. But if you are a beginner, then these things come at later on. From the very beginning, you try to understand these things and try to learn them, and you give so much importance and you sidetrack this basic thing. This is very, very important in practice. Then you get lost, because directly if you jump to the fourth stage, then you surely have big amount of failures, because homeopathy is also a kind of a staircase. It's not something a straight way, because as we have to study in KZ, then school, then high school, and then college. So if you are studying at college, then if you feel like this was, if I have to study in college, so what is importance of school and high school and all, then it's wrong, right? The same way, I observe in many students, they do not put lot of emphasis and they do not give even importance to study these basic things. They are able to find out the kingdoms and miasms and many multiple ways they come on the different medicines. But some person has a simple flu, but they are not able to trace out the symptoms, and you are not able to cure the flu. So if you are a homeopath and you are not able to handle the simple flu, then there might be somewhere the problem, right? So this is the issue. So in college days, students might be misguided, or I am not saying the misguided, but they do not have proper guidance. So this is the reason we bring this course, to create awareness. Like this is very important thing in important thing to study, and because it has a direct impact on clinical practice. So But each thing, each step that I showed here in PPT, each step has their own style. It's not something by just a night you can master that thing. First you have to recognize common symptoms. Even common symptoms are very useful in practice. Not only for diagnosis, for prescription, common symptoms are also useful. And common symptoms also help you to trace out peculiars. Because in acutes, generally you find peculiars around, nearby the common symptoms. That's why common symptoms are very important. Then after you have to trace out peculiars, you have to extract the peculiar, you try to complete the symptoms, then after mentals, and finally you have integration. So repertory is not solely gives you judgment to the medicine. You need to take support of other tools all the time. Either the keynotes, either the concepts, any kind of concept like Sankaran's concept, Vitulka's concept, Vijayakar's concept, Segal's concept, or either you can take a help of Materia Medica. So this is the way the story become complete. Now, for repertorization, I can say two type of repertorization is there. A factual repertorization and conceptual repertorization. I think you heard these words first, but I will make you understand. Factual means fact-oriented symptoms. Even in mind also, there are many, many symptoms. Suppose you have a fear of spider. Then there is no chance to interpret it. You have fear. Or you have fear of lizard or cockroach. Or suppose you have a fear of or dream of the fire. It's a fact. So this kind of fact related, it has no space to interpret. This is we call factual repertorization. And I use this kind of repertorization, or in my repertorization, the factual repertorization is a big part. I put trust on factual repertorization more than the conceptual repertorization. For conceptual repertorization, you use some delusions or for example, I give you example of Segal's style, light desire. Somebody want to know something, somebody want to understand something, somebody want to explore something. And doctor, during the narration, doctor recognize like person want a light, to put light, to understand, to explore something, and they take the rubric, light desire. So this is we called concept, right? It's not a fact. You interpret that person's narration, and according to your mindset, your understanding, you put them in repertorization. This is I call conceptual repertorization. It's just for the example, huh? This conceptual repertorization is there in every system, in every methodology. So, for initial homeopath who begin their repertory work, they do not have to include this kind of repertorization from very first day. It comes day by day in you, and finally you can use them. So this is one thing. Now, in repertorization or any kind of work, the focusing is very, very, very important. And this is the reason in group I ask one question. You have to know or use multiple repertory or one or two repertory. And we have a both kind of answer. Somebody says multiple repertory you have to master, and somebody says one or two is good. But I give you one example. there is one artist whose mentality is totally art kind, and one day he decided to let's have painting. I will master in paint. For 15 days he tried out, go in tuition, learn everything, and then he decided the poetry is also good, so let's try to make a poet kind of things. 15 days he tried, then after he decided it's not so good, so let's do sculpturing, making a sculpture from the clay and all, POP and all. And finally he think it's not, everything is not so good, better is music, you do not have to make your hands dirty, so music is good. So he bring that all harmonium and veena and all, and he try to focus on it. Same thing happen with us. One day, even this is happen especially for students. One day we learn something from somewhere and we decide this is good. Same thing happen with repertory also. One doctor show you the very good case from the Nair repertory and you jump out on Nair repertory. Another day in another seminar or somewhere or some in clinic or whatever way, in article you find the very good case treated with Phatak repertory. So your focus goes to Phatak. Then another day can coming up. Then fewer cases coming up, so you go to warning sign. And finally, you will learn nothing. So this is the reason you have to stay focused. Focusing for, because this is human psychology, you have to learn everything. But another human psychology is also there. You have capacity to understand one thing at one time. If you have a desire, and you can say infinite desire to learn lot of things, then learn. Homeopathy is kind of a ocean. Nobody is just trapping you or pulling you, right? Go there. But first, learn something that can you can use in your practice thoroughly. A master. Just you become a master in that thing. Then go for second. If the artist become a very good painter, then after he think I want to become a musician, then it's okay. But if you go everywhere and learn nothing, then it has no meaning. So this is very very important, especially in beginners. And this thing also happen with practitioners also. One day they learn from one teacher something, from another teacher something, from another teacher something, and they lost the focus. So this is very very important. Then better to focus on something, or at beginning just focus on those kind of cases which is daily you need to have in practice. And believe me, in practice there are 30 to 40% cases are very 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 simple. And this is the reason everywhere I say homeopathy is very very simple and easy thing, because of this. So first focus on that simple thing. We have a habit to always we try to find out something very unique or something extraordinary, because by heart we are a homeopath and always looking for something peculiar, unknown. And that's why from college, even during college time, when we read some cases or see some cases on Facebook, social media, like one doctor has cured HIV, heart attack or cancer cases, and we directly try to cure the cancer cases. But this is not good for health. Especially a practitioner's health. Because tough thing you have to select at last. These are the tough things. You have to select something which is very, very simple. I want to share my college days story. I remember I was a kind of student who do not focus on anything. But I use one technique. When I study, I see something which is very, very important and easy to grasp. I learn them easily. And I left that which is very tough in study, and I left them. And I study or I try to look over them just at a glance, not at depth. And this is the reason I never fail in college. And I think this is all students a normal psychology. We need important, right? Important, even we go to our teachers also. Sir, take us for important questions, right? So, this is important thing. This is also very, very important in practice also. You have to focus on a very easy, very simple, easily accessible kind of cases. Once you start over them, then you can go and you can evolve and you have pathological cases. You remove the tumors, cataract, many things are there in homeopathy. You can treat thyroid cases, you can treat PCOD cases, many things are there. Infertility cases, many things, diabetes cases. But from very beginning you start with them, then it's become very hard. So first focus on something very easy, that is my main learning. And in this way, if you try to apply clinically this idea, then surely your practice gets established within short time. If you are a practitioner, then your practice becomes double. And I'm not just joking. This is my second repertory course. Earlier we finished repertory course and 65 homeopaths are there. It was a paid course, and even most experienced homeopath who has a practice of 30-35 years, they also feel like after finishing the course, they see the bloom of the patient in their practice. They see a big difference after the course, and because this is directly you can apply in your practice. It's a clinical thing. It's going to help you. So this is, I want to say, I just go out of the track. Now, this is the way systematically we can learn everything. So you have here everything systematically, step by step. Easy, simple, then hard, and then integration. But we do not left you to just teach you and just left you, just go on your way. We are always with you. And that's why the course has mentoring also. Every step of your development, we are with you. Me and my team. And we are going to guide you. Where you are making mistake. What is in reality. What is need to be added in your thoughts. So this is real clinical, practical kind of training. So this is the way. This is the main, you can say, the crux of this course. Repertory courses are there in everywhere, I see. Even you can learn repertories in many seminars, in books, and in colleges, and anybody's clinic. Many ways, in CMEs, in workshops, seminars. But this is something different because we just not giving you dry lecturings. We are mentoring you and we try to uplift you one level upper. It's not by night you become a master in repertory, but wherever you are, just you uplift one level for sure. Now, we'll talk about the entire program of the course. In course, we'll provide you videos. Videos to guide you, just for this kind of videos, like I'm guiding you how the course is going on. We will share several things, our thoughts. Not only me, but my entire team will share a different videos. We are creating awakening. So this way you become aware, like what is the real homeopathy. It's a not kind of a homeopathy in generals, in seminars and in articles. It's a real, you see, you feel the homeopathy in front of you. This is our best effort. And this is our teaching technique. Then after, we have a rubric exercises. Every day, we will provide you a one patient's own words expression. Like, doctor, from the morning I have a very severe abdominal pain in my iliac region. And you have to find out the rubric, abdomen, pain, lower abdomen or iliac region. This is rubric you have to find out. This way exercise we will provide you. This is just simple example, but you have some difficult rubrics also. So this is the way you become aware of the structure of the repertory in short time. Where is the chapter? What chapter has what symptoms? What kind of rubrics? Or suppose some peculiar word you have to search in repertory. How would you can? So this is the, you can say that you become friendlier with the repertory. And this is very, very important. This is we hardly see in anywhere in homeopathy. Nobody is making exercise on rubrics. So this is we call, this is the reason we put the word training in the heading of the course. But we will not just teaching you. We will just holding your hand and just walk with you. So you can feel safe, you can understand the better, and wherever you are going to make a mistake, we try to correct them. So we will always walk with you. Another thing in the course is case exercises, and this is the main heart of the course. We will give you the cases from me or my team or anybody, any homeopath case. And you have to hunt the peculiars from it, the words or expression you have to select, and for that word or expression you have to find out the exact rubric in the repertory, and you have to send me back in our WhatsApp group, right? And if needed, I will guide you. Like somebody is making a big mistake. A smaller mistake, you can avoid. But if you are making a big mistake, then we will guide you like you are making mistake. Actually, the meaning of this expression is this and you think something else. But how would you know, like this is my mistake? Suppose we do not guide you, then how would you know? For this reason, after decided time, like suppose I give you a 1 week, after the week, I will put my analysis for the case, entire case taking process, everything I will explain in that paper. I put my repertory chart and I even extracted, so I made a polarity of the case, portrait of the case, extracted that peculiar expression. And this peculiar expression, I have selected this rubric. This is I put there. So you can understand, this kind of expression, you have to think for this rubric. And you can compare your repertory work with my repertory work. So you get understand, like this is I had made mistake. So this is real training, right? And I will share you multiple different level cases, not same level cases. one acute case, one peculiar repertory case, one case where you use the different type of repertory, one case where conformation pattern is little different, this way. So this is our duty. We are just showing you the path, but you have to develop. You have that eagerness, you have that burning desire to learn something, you need to be enthusiastic, you need to be active, then only the things comes in you, otherwise not. We are ready. Our team is putting a lot of effort. Imagine, we are mentoring one to one level nearly 500 or more than 500 to 700 students daily. It's a very, very Herculean task. But we are ready to put that effort. No problem. We are dedicated. If you are dedicated the same level, the progress will ensure for sure. So this is the reason. As like Arjun, the Mahabharata character, right? You need to be very focused, very awakened, very, very active, studious. So, the course is not just kind of a gossiping or making a simple talk and all that good morning, afternoon, birthday wishes, right? Then the course is just, this is the way we can grow ourselves from one step to a next level. So, this is our main motto. Let's grow together. It's not effort of one person. It's not my course. It's our course. We will learn together. If you are not there, then there is a no course. If I am not there, then there is a no course. If we get together, then we have a beautiful learning, a growth of everybody. So whatever concept you belong, whatever experience level you are, whatever practice you have, don't worry. Be with us and we are 100% sure you are uplifting one level for sure. So this is the course. This is about the explanation of the course. Let's have journey together. This is the reason I put the entire series name Journey with Dr. Kalathya. Actually, it's a big story. Journey of Dr. Kalathya has presented many, many courses about plant kingdom, about animal kingdom, about mineral kingdom, about mammals, about birds, about case taking, about repertory, about acutes. So, it's a compact thing. And this is our next presentation, our next project to make you aware about repertory. Thank you so much, friends.